हरे कृष्णा। आई एम अर्चना भक्ति राधा देवी दासी। आई एम एसोसिएटेड विद चेन्नई स्कॉन। आई बिलोंग टू उत्तर प्रदेश ऑफ दिस कंट्री इंडिया।
हाउ यू मीट द डिवोटीज, हाउ यू जॉइन?
आई वॉज प्रैक्टिसिंग क्रिया योग बिफोर आई जॉइंड स्कॉन एंड I suddenly developed interest in knowing Bhagavad Gita. So, somebody taught me Bhagavad Gita, not Bhagavad Gita as it is, just they were like Brahmavadis, I think, from whom I learned. But when I saw that, you know, it said Bhagwan Uvacha and what the Lord said, I was very interested to know about Lord Krishna. So, the next thing is, who is Krishna? How will I know about him? So that's when I realized ki okay SCON, International Society for Krishna Consciousness. So I was that time in Salem. So I asked a friend of mine ki is there a SCON here? So she said yes. So I went there and I met Gokul Chandra Prabhu, His Grace Gokul Chandra Prabhu. And he told me certain things. He was very, very gentle and you know, he just said, yeah, that's very nice what you're doing, this, that. And he told me, you know, just chant. And then he asked a few questions. The answers really, I really loved the answers. I said, yes, it makes a lot of sense to me. So I was practicing Kriya Yoga, but simultaneously I started to chant also. So my Kriya Yoga practice was, say, about 2 hours or so, a meditation and all that. So as I went on chanting, I loved chanting and I gradually, I mean, my Kriya practice just weaned off. And then he was taking, I think there was this Bhagavatam class every Monday. So I started attending those classes. I really loved to hear, it was very, very interesting for me. I wouldn't miss a class to the best of my capacity. So I started hearing and meanwhile, we got transferred from Salem to Thanjavur. And Thanjavur is, say, I think about 3.5 or maybe 4 hours run from, the distance between Thanjavur and Salem is about 4 hours, 3.5, 4 hours. So every Monday I used to travel that much to attend the class because there was no congregation in Thanjavur. Yeah, so that's how, and then gradually then my husband, he got transferred to Chennai. So in between what happened, I think once while I was in Salem, I went to, because of the devotees, you hear about so many things. I had a friend of mine, she would tell me a lot about Krishna consciousness. So I went with her and one more friend of mine to Mayapur. That's when many stalls where many sannyasis were giving lectures. So I went into the thing of His Holiness Jayapataka Swami Maharaj. So when I saw him, I immediately, I was very attracted towards him and deep inside I knew he's my guru. So I heard him and I paid my obeisances and within my heart I sort of requested him ki I don't know how qualified I am, but if you would accept me as my disciple, I would be I couldn't have asked for more, something like that. So that was it. Then after that we got transferred to Chennai and to my surprise Chennai was under His Holiness Jayapataka Swami Maharaj. And then the journey began. So that's how I came here.
Can you tell us how was your interview for initiation with Guru Maharaj? Or your initiation, how was your name, meaning, everything with Guru Maharaj?
In my family, we had a bad experience with my sister. So, she got some tantric, he did Vashikaran on her. So my family were very against all these things. And especially when you get initiation, there's always a thing, the name changes. Right. So my name was Archana. My karmic name was Archana itself. So I was. They said that would you like to get initiation for Guru Maharaj, because I was already prepared. So I said yes. That was very nice for me. And so I kept within myself. I kept praying to Guru Maharaj ki you understand my family situation. I mean, my first name, if it is secured, then it'll be easy for me. I mean, I will not have to have conflicts with my family members. I kept praying to him. I didn't ask him anything. I didn't tell anything to anybody. I kept praying. So I got my initiation, I think somewhere in 2018 or 19, and it was in Gaur Purnima day in Mayapur. Yeah. So Guru Maharaj was there, and so when I learned that my name was Archana Bhakti Radha Devi Dasi, I was really thrilled. So there's a connection. You don't have to be face to face. And Guru Maharaj has always said that you pray to me deeply within your heart, and I'm there. So I always believe that. So that came very true, and my faith was still, it got strengthened. So that is how I got my initiation, and I got my name also.
Any other moment or memory with Guru Maharaj?
Guru Maharaj was here for his treatment, and that time this in Kanchipuram we had this Ativardar. You can see Ativardar after 40 years. So in 2019 that was the time. 2019 I think. 19. Yes, I think 2019, is it? Ativardar. I think so, 2019. So Guru Maharaj had come, Guru Maharaj was here, and he also wanted to take darshan. So since my husband has this police background, so I got the opportunity. I didn't know if I will be able to do anything at all, because it was very new for me also. So Ajita Prabhu said, would you be able to manage to help us that Guru Maharaj can take easy darshan? I said, yes, I will be able to help you, please. I just opened. I said, I don't know what will happen. I don't know myself. I said, yes, please, I will. I'll do my best. So there were some police people there when we went. It was very crowded, very, very crowded. And Guru Maharaj also came. I was very happy because I was nobody, and Guru Maharaj laid his faith on me. His servants laid faith on me. I was very, very happy about that, unconditionally, because I don't know anything of that sort. All I knew is ki, okay, if at all even I take darshan, if it is with Guru Maharaj, I couldn't have asked for more, because you can't take darshan of the Lord without your Guru. So I was very happy. And we tried our best, and Guru Maharaj's servants, they all were there, and whatever I could do, I did. But I would only say that all that happened, it's only Guru Maharaj's mercy. It looks as if, I am the doer, but I didn't do anything. It is just his mercy flowed, and things just happened. Now today when I look, can I do it again? It was like, no, Baba, it is very difficult. But Guru Maharaj made it very, very easy. So that is one of my experiences with him. And he's very, very kind, compassionate. So whenever he sees me, he remembers Ativardhar. So that is just his mercy. In fact, I could take darshan of Ativardhar because of him. So it looks like that. So that is one nice experience with Guru Maharaj. Then Guru Maharaj often comes to Chennai for his thing. So he gives darshan whenever he comes to Ajita Prabhu's house. So we get the chance to see him, and he's very cordial, and off late also, I think some 2-3 months back, he was here, and Ajita Prabhu arranged for the meeting with Guru Maharaj, and my husband had a few questions. So he's not into ISKCON. So, but Ajit Prabhu encouraged him, and that's how he and me, we went to Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj has such a busy schedule, but in spite of that, Guru Maharaj gave us some 30 minutes. He gave us half an hour, his exclusive time. We had a question answer session with Guru Maharaj. My husband asked a lot of questions, and he answered. It was very, very nice. I mean, you can't ask for more. And of course, we all know how Guru Maharaj is like, how he's in that body, and how he's working for all of us. He wants to be in touch with all of us. He does not, never wants to make us feel ki we are far away or maybe, you know, distances can make a difference. I think it's all within the heart, and Guru Maharaj is there. Many a times I felt, because sometimes when I feel little, because I should not say alone, but if sometimes we feel, because I'm not to that level, so sometimes when you feel left out or alone and all that, and you pray for protection, somehow or the other, Guru Maharaj, you get certain signs that, you know, the Guru Maharaj protects us. So that is a very great thing. So these are my few little experiences of Guru Maharaj.
One question, how you see Guru Maharaj following Srila Prabhupada's instructions?
Guru Maharaj is like, he is the epitome, I would say. Every instruction of Srila Prabhupada he has tried to follow. I think he lives Srila Prabhupada. I only think that. Yes, in every ways, because when you read Prabhupada's Leelamrita, and then when you see Guru Maharaj, he's exemplifying what a disciple should be. So I see it like that, Matab. He simply exemplifies. I don't know much though, because, you know, but whatever little bit I know, I see it like that. And whatever I know through, because it is Guru Maharaj, it's, and disciples of Srila Prabhupada who have given us Prabhupada. We have not seen Prabhupada. The way they have given us Prabhupada is exemplary. It's beautiful. So I see them also live that life. And Guru Maharaj also, he is given his entire life for what Prabhupada has said. Even now he carries to do that. So it's amazing.
Any dream or instruction from Guru Maharaj?
No, I didn't get any dream per se. And instructions, of course, he gives instructions every now and then, and he tells, like, his lectures are full of that, but not particularly, not that to a particular person like that, I didn't get any instruction. He asked me once, your husband has non-veg? I said, yes, Guru Maharaj. Do you cook for him? I said, no, and that was it. I don't know what exactly it was, but he just said that and it was okay. So, and I had this Gaur Nithai deities, so I wanted, that time Guru Maharaj was there, so I took my deities and I asked Guru Maharaj to, you know, give them the names. So, first Guru Maharaj asked me, he, can you bathe them daily? I said, Guru Maharaj, I'm all alone at home, I can't do it. Then he says, okay, twice in a week. I said, no, I can't do it. They said, nothing is left, you have to do it twice, once in fortnight. I said, every day Ekadashi. I said, yeah, Guru Maharaj, I can't do it. So he is very compassionate, he understands, so he helps us to, in whichever way we can do our best, he helps us do that. So it is his mercy, nothing else.
So, if you remember something else?
As of now, nothing per se.
What's your impression to see Guru Maharaj first time in Mayapur?
Yeah.
Oh, you saw him first time in
Mayapur.
I don't know, you have been in the Vyasapuja or Parikrama or some events?
Not Parikrama. I think that time in Mayapur they had every sannyasi or the spiritual masters, they had one pavilion to themselves where they would come and speak. So Guru Maharaj pavilion was also there. I went there. So that's when I saw him that time, first time. And my friend was there. She said he's such an exalted soul, and she really glorified him. And I could sense that whatever she was saying, she meant it from the bottom of her heart. I didn't know Guru Maharaj that time. So the way she explained to me, I was very touched. And of course, when I saw him also, when he spoke also, he was on the wheelchair that time. And when I see his old pictures, so I feel he's such a, like a lion, he's so powerful, and so I wish I could, you know, but then it does not make a difference, it's just a wish that, you know, I could have his association even earlier, I feel like that, not just towards the end. So, but anyways, whatever the Lord decides, this itself is a great mercy. So whatever I have, like, I'll cherish and I'll make the most of it. Thank you so much, Mataji. Hare Krishna. Thank you for the wonderful opportunity. Hare Krishna.